If you're this kind of plant, you don't want to be living in the deserts of Las Vegas, which can easily reach over 100 degrees Fahrenheit or 38 degrees Celsius in temperature and receive only around 11 centimeters of rainfall yearly. So what do the mighty desert plants do differently to be able to live in such environments? It's not easy. There's a reason why forests are not seen in the desert. Firstly, it's all about finding water and retaining it. Succulents, called so for their juicy inside, like cacti and desert aloe, have extra large vacuole storage in their inside for water storage. A thick layer of wax called a cuticle shields the outside of succulents from water loss, while many succulents also have sharp thorns to deter thirsty predators. The saguaro cactus, in fact, does not have deep roots to tap into water deep underground. It simply waits out the drought, even if that means sitting and baking in the sun for years. The mesquite tree has a totally different approach, poisoning nearby trees with its side roots and drilling down over 200 feet to tap into underground water with its deep roots. Crassulation acid metabolism, or CAM for short, means these plants only open their stomata, the site of plant gas exchange for carbon dioxide and oxygen, in the cooler night to avoid too much water from being evaporated out from open stomata during the hot day. However, water retention is not the only strategy desert plants use. Many desert non-succulents do not even have specialized vacuole storage. Instead, some have narrow leaves which don't become heated as much from the sun or lose water as fast as large, flat leaves. Palisade cells, cells which have many chloroplasts for photosynthesis, are more densely packed in the leaves of many desert non-succulents to maximize photosynthesis in a more narrow leaf area. As with succulents though, non-succulents have waxy cuticles and CAM metabolism. There's even a tumbleweed called the resurrection plant, which dries up and is tossed around by the wind until rain comes. It can roll around in its dry state for 100 years, and water makes it swell up, unfurl, and begin seeding new seedlings within minutes, after which the dryness makes it and its offspring shrivel up again to repeat this process. All sorts of unique adaptations may be seen simply by examining the abilities of desert plants. Hopefully now a cactus doesn't just seem like a big senseless ball of spikes, and hopefully we'll never have to see a world where the only plants able to live are cacti.